Now in this video, I am going to explain very important topic of group 16. It is the oxoacids of sulphur. So first we will know what are oxoacids. Actually, they are the compounds, they are the substances formed when the sulphur oxides are dissolved into water, and they have the OH group, as well as they have at least double bond O. So see first the definition. So oxoacids are the substances obtained when the oxides of non-metals, when the oxides of non-metals are dissolved in water, they are dissolved into water and have few OH groups attached to the non-metal, attached to the non-metal, and at least one double bond O group. So this is the identification that they have few, it can be one or two, and so these are the prime conditions OH and at least one double bond. Actually, oxoacids are formed of all the non-metals like nitrogen, sulfur, phosphorus, they all form the oxoacids, and this is the identification. So sulfur forms several oxoacids. It forms several oxoacids when the oxides are dissolved into water. Oxides are dissolved into water. Like most important, H2O suppose sulfuric acid, then there is sulfurous acid, and there are many more. So this is the statement of the oxoacid. Now we'll see the structure of oxoacids. Now see, the structures are very much significant, and the structures, they explain the nature and the character of the oxoacids of any, whether it is phosphorus or sulfur or nitrogen. Now see, many are there, but these are some important ones. So first is the sulfuric acid, H2SO4. See, it has the tetrahedral shape and it has two double bond O, two oxo groups and two OH groups. But point is very important to note in mind that the OH group is non-ionizable and they are not having the basic character. In fact, they are acidic. And no, sulfuric acid, it is dibasic acid. Keep in mind that this bond, SO bond, is very strong, and so only H ion can be released from this sulfuric acid. Now coming to this sulfurous acid, H2SO3. So this, it has a lone pair of electron, it has two OH groups, and here just, it has tetrahedral molecule. This is having this tetrahedral, this, and this is, this has pentadimer molecule. Now this is per oxo disulfuric acid, H2SO8, this. So here it has two per oxo disulfuric acid, two moles of it, a dimer of sulfuric acid, and so H2SO8, and so it is also a dibasic acid. Now coming to this last, it is, per oxo sulfuric acid, or it is commonly called as polyum. Commonly it is called as polyum. So see, two sulfur, two this, two on one sulfur, two on one sulfur, and one OH and one H here. So this is about the oxoacids of sulfur and their structure. Now You will see very important oxoacid, sulphuric acid, just as of 4. It is one of the most important chemical throughout the world because it has used in many things. Metallurgy, you know, acid accumulators. It is as a chemical in processing of metals, refining of petroleum, and there are lot many uses. Now, it is prepared by a very important process, and you know, it is very much significant. It is very much significant also. It is prepared by contact process. It is prepared by contact process, and it involves first step. In first step, the sulphur is burned to get SO2. This is the first step, and the sulphur is burned. Sulphur is burned in presence of oxygen to form the SO2 gas, elemental sulphur, octatomic sulphur. But rarely it is not used. Actually, sulfuric acid in most of the cases it is obtained as a byproduct of the SO2 from the processing of the metals like, you know, sulfide ores. So, you know, sulfide ores during the conversion into metal, they liberate lot of SO2. So, in essence, SO2 is not wasted, and so this is there. Now, second step, it is conversion of SO2 into SO3, and for this, the SO2 gas in presence of V2O5 cation, actually it is catalytic oxidation at very high temperature, around 1100 Kelvin temperature, and it is converted to SO3 gas. So this is the second step. Now third step is the last step, and in this the dissolution of SO3 into H2SO4 to get oleum. Oleum or H2SO7. So H2SO4 plus SO3 gas here, and there is S2O7. This is oleum. Now there is one point. If you write here, say here I write SO3 plus S2O, there is formation of H2SO4, and this equation is valid. This reaction is valid. But actually, in reality, this is highly exothermic reaction. Very large amount of heat is generated. And you know, the Chatelier's principle is involved everywhere. And what happens when it is exothermic in nature? It means as, you know, temperature increases, what happens? The solubility of the gas decreases. So this process is not done in real practice on large scale. It prevents the formation of sulfuric acid and so on. Now this is a very brief introduction, and there are different processes, and there is arsenic purifier also. Arsenic purifier in the plant, arsenic purifier is also there, because arsenic acts as negative catalyst. It acts as negative catalyst. That is, it prevents the formation of SO3 from SO2. So arsenic purifier is actually iron hydroxide. Iron hydroxide is used. So, you know, it is passed completely. And arsenic, because why arsenic is present? Because arsenic is found in association with sulfur, and so arsenic has to be removed. So this is going to be negative catalyst effect, and so this is about the preparation of sulfuric acid. So oleum is are mixed with water to get the concentrated sulfuric acid. Now coming to the properties, so it is colorless. It is a colorless, slightly dense liquid, or you can say it is slightly slippy liquid. It has, you know, a slippery appearance, just sticky appearance. You might have noticed in the laboratories, it sticks. It is having more density. It is having more density. Now, it has very high heat of hydration. Very high heat of hydration, meaning is that very large amount of heat is generated when it dissolves sulfuric acid. So care must be taken. Care must be taken to add sulfuric acid. Add sulfuric acid concentrated to water with constant stirring. This is 1 point, constant stirring, and in little amount. Constant stirring and in little amount. Why? Because if you add little amount of acid with constant stirring, what happens? Heat is also generated, but the heat generated is small, and then the dissipation of heat goes away, and so as a result, it prevents the spillage and the spoilage of any acid, or any chance of accident is minimized. Now, it is very strong, very strong oxidizing and dibasic acid. Very strong sulfuric acid. You know, it is dissociated into this. And here, this acid dissociation constant, if you take this, so here we have, and this sulfate ions, and this is there, and so this. So here, K is very high. Why is it very high? Because after dissociation, the strength of H is highest, and so it is very strong acid. The chemical properties, the strong chemical character of HSF4 is due to different points, and first is its very low volatile character. Low volatile character means it do not give away fumes. You can see in laboratory sulfuric acid, nitric acid, when we open, it gives off fumes, but it is not volatile. This is most important point. Second is, it has very strong affinity, very strong affinity for water, and you know, very large amount of heat is generated, and so this is one of the most important. And this dissociation constant, its dissociation constant Ka is very high. Dissociation constant is very high. And the last one is its strong oxidizing character. So, you know, these 4 points make sulfuric acid is one of the strongest acid. So, it's low volatile nature, so it can, you know, oxidize anything. So, this is our point, number one. Now, other point is, it can oxidize metals and non-metals, both metals and non-metals both, and you know, it forms sulfates. It forms sulfates with either metals or the compounds of metals or metal compounds. Like you take copper. So copper plus sulfuric acid, there is formation of copper sulfate plus there is the formation of water. Similarly, if you take copper carbonate plus sulfuric acid, there is formation of copper sulfate plus CO2 plus H2O. So this is the also oxidation of the this copper and copper carbonate. So this is very important point. Now, as you know, it is having very poor volatile character, so it can be used to prepare more volatile halogen acids or hydrogen acids. So due to its poor volatility, it can be used to prepare more volatile acids. More volatile acids can be prepared. If you take any metal salt, let be the metal salt and then sulfuric acid. So this sulfuric acid, it forms, you know, HX plus there is formation of MSO4. Here this X, it can be, you know, chloride, it can be bromide, it can be iodide, it can be nitrate, etc. So, you know, hydrogen halides are more volatile. Hydrogenides are more volatile. And so, you know, so it is less volatile. So, if you take any metal salt, so it can be used to. Now, other is, this is the formation of a strong acid. Also, we need very important charring action. Charring means char. Char means burn to carbon. Carbonification. So when it is poured over, you know, any material like carbohydrate or starch or sugar or anything or glucose, it removes water molecules because it has very strong dehydrating character, very strong oxidizing character. So if you take, you know, C12S22O11, this is, you know, sugar, and here you take the sulfuric acid concentrated, let it be heat slightly, so it forms here carbon. This carbon black, there is formation of carbon black and there is formation of 12S2. This is called as charring action. Now, last but very important point about the reaction with some metals and non-metals. See, if you take copper, concentrated sulfuric acid, and heat is required. And so, there is formation of copper sulfate, but here, you know, it is, you know, able to produce SO2 and then the water. Now, with the non-metal, sulfur, you know, it is oxidized to SO2. Then carbon, it can be oxidized to CO2 and this is. So this is very important point. It is a strong oxidizing agent. Now last is, you know, it is the usage. So usage, you know, as electrolyte in acid accumulators, you know, acid batteries, lead storage batteries, then in preparation of drugs, dyes, pigments, explosives, there, you know, sulfuric acid is very important. It is queen of the chemicals. Then in processing, refining, there. Then in metallurgical operations like cleaning of metals, electroplating, etc. So this is very important topic, and this is, you know, very important concept about the sulfuric acid.